particular commission piece, three PhDs, very competent in economics, who did a study that's actually, despite their sophisticated credentials, the actual study was quite simple. And the study was this: we heard all of this framing from the other side that, oh, we're not going to, sacrifice lives to the economy. If it's just a matter of saving one more life from COVID, we're going to shut down the economy indefinitely. And this just makes the case in a rigorous kind of quantitative fashion that you cannot separate people's lives from their livelihoods, that there are demonstrable health effects to economic suffering. And it draws upon the pre-existing economic literature of what are the expected health effects, what are the expected deaths from any delta increase in unemployment. And it puts all those pieces together and say, look, from all these lockdowns, we're ending up, ruining a lot more people's lives than we are saving. And, it's the president, I know for a fact, read that study. It's been reflected in his vocabulary. He tweeted it. Several congressmen tweeted it. It's had a real impact on the conversation. And the real kind of scandal is that, I love Revolver News. The real scandal is no one else had done this. And the people involved in the study who had to publish it under pseudonyms for fear of retaliation within their respective positions, including in academia, in terms of getting more grant money and all this, there's all kinds of retaliation and professional pressure if you deviate from the COVID narrative. But it's a scandal that nobody had done this. And this is like the most monumental public policy decision made maybe ever. It's simply unprecedented to shut down the entire economy indefinitely over a disease, let alone a disease whose victims' average age is higher than the age of life expectancy. We didn't even shut down due to the 1918 epidemic, whose average age of fatality was 28. COVID's average age is like 80, 79. And we shut down the entire economy. So, this is another conversation. I think it's, maybe one of the greatest crimes against humanity. It is absolute public policy travesty, the effects of which we're only beginning to see. And I'm very proud of this study on Revolver that just goes through all the literature and says, look, the lockdowns themselves are 10 times more deadly than the disease. And that's taking into account generously all of the reported statistics. So if you're actually, I think it's actually worse than that, but we, for the sake of argument, took for granted all the numbers that the government had in terms of how many COVID deaths there were and so forth. But it's an absolute scandal, and it's just deeply depressing. I don't think most people have like the psychological fortitude to truly look into the face, the magnitude of this crime against the people for nothing.
Yeah, absolutely. I remember when I first came across that study on Revolver, I was so excited. I mean, not excited in an elated sense, but I was so happy that someone had done that because it is such a useful piece of information to be able to present. And so I guess speaking broadly to the audience, creating narratives or contributing to the narratives, contributing anything, whether it's commissioning studies like that, things like with what Revolver's doing, commentary channels, not to pat myself on the back, but like doing something and putting your name out there and then bringing other people's names and faces into it. Anonymous Twitter accounts are great. Consuming information is great, but ultimately, whether that's monetarily or like structurally, everyone's going to have to contribute something and make it, broadly speaking, like their life's goal if they're really passionate about this country and its future. So Dr. Beattie, very glad to have you. I think it was a great discussion, and we'll do it again sometime.
Wonderful. Thank you for having me.
Of course. So with that, here we are. Election day is tomorrow. Very excited. Make sure you get your three people to go with you to vote. The undecideds, the people that are maybe leaning Biden. But we will see what happens. It's going to be very epic. Very excited for the future. We're optimistic. We're optimistic on a lot of things, not only this channel's future. But I mean, if there were ever a plan or a means by which we could take back the country and get it in a positive trajectory, Dr. Beattie is going to be one of the leading architects in that. So be sure to go check him out on Twitter. Be sure to go to revolver.news. That's where I get my news. People are like, where do you get your news? Revolver. I mean, it saves me a lot of time. But anyways, thank you so much for watching, and we will see you next time.
ancestors watch.
Have anything ancient to trade? Needs to be at least 2 centuries old. If you find anything exotic, bring it to me.
Greetings, traveler.
ancient to trade needs to be at least 2 centuries old. If you find anything exotic, bring it to me. Anything ancient to trade needs to be at least 2 centuries old. If you find anything exotic, bring it to me.